Yo, yo, yo. Donk and Dave here. Day number 51 of the Take It Easy Tour. Take it easy. And we stayed last night here in Port de Basse, or whatever it's called, in Newfoundland. 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 And hung out with some other motorcyclists, and man, it was just so good to be with people that were of the same thought process and everything, and they were good, and we had some brews and just had some food and good conversation and fellowship, and if you want to call it fellowship, but you know, it's just good. It's just good to be with people that are of the same mind that you are. And if you are a person, this is my advice, if you are a person that is lonely or sad or whatever, you know, seek out people that have the same interests that you do and hang out with them. And learn from them and gather some information from them and have friendships and establish bonds with people that have the same mindset that you do, same interests. Now, hopefully, you know, you're not a, you know, axe murderer or anything like that, but seek those people out and, you know, they'll help you. Hopefully you're not, you know, going to an association of the terminally, you know, depressed or whatever, you know, but just do that, you know, and they'll help you out. Just being with people will help you out tremendously. And I know people that have gone through rough times and they go into a shell and they stay in that shell. And you just can't do that. I mean, you just can't. So, get out there and meet some folks and be with people and they'll help you out. You know, when I say that, I've got a friend that his wife left him and he just has never really recovered. He's never dated after his wife left him. He never, you know, got a girlfriend or anything like that. And he's just a sad person. And he's content to be that way. But it's just, that's just not the way life ought to be, guys. So if you're sad, you know, find some people that'll help you. And it'll get better. Believe me, I know. Well, all right, we're going to see what we can get into. We're in Newfoundland. Donk and Dave out. So I'm looking around here in Newfoundland, and I just stopped into the visitor center. And whenever you get into a state or a new place, if they have a visitor center, go in there and glean information out of those folks, because they've got the information, they got the inside track on the stuff that you need to know. And so, and also got a free map, which was absolutely fantastic to get. Always get a free map if you can get a free map. And I utilize, you know, the GPS and Google Maps and everything, but there really is more information that you can get out of a paper map than anything else. So get those maps, guys. But I'm looking around, and the first thing that comes to mind is no trees. Or at least if there are trees here, there's just not too many of them. You know what? It's just kind of the way that it is here. Not too many trees. And they had a sign up that said, "Be moose aware." And apparently there are moose all over the place here in Newfoundland. So I'll have to keep my eyes open here for moose. And not ride at night, and not ride, you know, just not ride at night. That's the big thing. Don't ride at night. So I mean, what can we say? It's freaking Newfoundland, man. It's Newfoundland. I'm nervously thrilled about this ride because it's remote to a certain extent. And if the bike breaks down, I'm in real trouble. And it's kind of like riding in Alaska, you know. You just don't know what you're going to get yourself into. My rear tire on the bike is starting to show some signs of wear. I think I've got about 4,600 miles on it, and I think I read that it would last up to 6,500 to 7,000 miles, something like that. Some guys looked at it yesterday and they said I got about 1,500 miles left on it. So, you know, I don't know. I'm babying this tire as much as I can so that I can get as many miles out of it as I can. So we'll see how that goes. But look at this landscape. It is just absolutely fantastic. I mean, look at, there's still snow over there on that mountain, or that hill over there. There's still snow on it. I can see that right now. How cool is that? Snow in July. Crazy. So, I'm just riding north right now. I'm on the Trans-Canada Highway, and we're just going to ride north as much as we want and see what we can see. And I've got a few spots to hit, but we'll just see what it looks like. And if anything comes up, we'll point it out. So we're just going to continue on. Donk and Dave out. All right, we're coming into an area that's a high wind area, and I don't think I'm going to have any problem with that right now. But this is called Table Mountains right here. And it's just a big ridge coming out of nothing. And then you got two boobies right here. That's pretty cool looking. Of course, I've got a dirty mind, so I'm always thinking about that. But but how neat, you know, these Table Mountains right here. That's cool. Cool. Two boobies. Going in between two boobies. That's neat. That's fun. That's funny right there. I don't care who you are. All right. Talking to you. Guys, just look at the landscape here. It is just incredible, and I think it's just gonna get better as time goes on as I head north. We're headed north on the Trans-Canada Highway, like I said before, and this is on the western side of Newfoundland. And that way over there is the ocean after you cross over those mountains. And then over there, there's just a whole lot of mountains and nothing over there. But wow, the scenery here is fan-freaking-tastic. Okay guys, it's starting to get good. We're riding through a canyon now. And it was looking pretty good here. We got a lot more to see here in the future, but this is just a little sample of what we got coming up. Sweet.
on, even on all this time.